All right, we are back. Thanks, virtual audience, for joining us again for more interviews. Here I have Kenneth from CA.
Yes, thank you.
Great to have you here today. Thought it would be kind of relevant. So CA as a company, for those out there that have been testers for a long time, have probably seen some changes, right, about what CA was and where they are today. So maybe we were talking about, before we got started, a little bit about your journey just inside CA and transformation.
Sure.
So if you could talk a little about that, I think that would be great.
Yeah, so I've been with CA through a couple tours, and you know, seeing CA, kind of what I call classic CA, was around operations products. You know, originally I was involved with some of the operations products around application performance monitoring, and you know, it was all about just, there was just a lot of different various products from an operations perspective.
Yeah.
When was with ITKO when we got acquired, we came in and CA really built this DevOps vision.
Mm-hmm.
So it was a big transformation inside of CA to see going from just being operations focused to now more focused all the way across the SDLC.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and in a vision of, okay, here's what we're looking at and here's how we're going to get there.
Mm-hmm.
And then it was a story around where are the gaps, and then we either built products in-house or acquired other companies to fill those holes. And that was, and as I tell people, it was like turning the Titanic. I mean, and it's, it has been a great journey, and it's been an incredible transformation to see CA go through.
Yeah, and I know for some of the folks out there that say, you know, how do you do that? Like, what were some of the critical components to be able to turn that ship, right? Because it may seem insurmountable when you're in an organization that has a lot of legacy and history and has a, you know, brand, so to speak, right, of being known for a particular thing. Getting people to see you as more than that, or getting people to see you as different or current in terms of the tools and technologies, you know, any words of wisdom or advice for folks on
so,
what you've seen work?
Yeah, I mean, it's to make the digital transformation happen is the first thing that has to happen is you kind of have a culture change.
Yeah.
Right. It's getting people bought into it. And it does take some work. I mean, it is, and it's once people start seeing the success, then they start buying in.
Yeah.
Then they're like, you know, wow, why didn't we do this earlier?
Yeah.
You know, so, and that's what I've seen within CA and with even our large customers.
Yeah.
And it's taking those baby steps. Mm-hmm. And you just, and I say, it's, you know, it is turning a very large ship in that right direction. And you can't just do it on a dime.
Mm-mm.
You've got to take those steps to go forward. Once you change the culture, then you can start changing the processes to make things fit in. And then it's about, once you have the processes, then it's about making sure you have the right tools in place, the right solutions to make it happen.
Yeah. So I think chunking it out, right, and saying, are we willing to make a culture change and understanding that's required, you know?
Yeah.
How do we decide where to focus, and then deciding which areas are going to be key, creating those processes, making sure those work, and then implementing the right tools to help you do it and get visibility to it.
Right, right, yeah. And that's been, you know, I said it's been a challenge at times, but it has really paid off.
Yeah.
And once we got a lot of people bought into it, and starting to, you know, swing in towards more agile methodologies and stuff.
Yeah.
It's really changed the way all of the software at CA is developed.
Yep.
And getting in and how we're developing and releasing our software.
Yeah. Now, in terms of your talk here, so you spoke on service virtualization?
Yes.
So maybe give a little insight to the folks out there on what your thoughts are in that space and how to get started on that, and think about it if you haven't.
Absolutely. Yeah. So, we know I talked about DevOps as our original vision, and kind of evolved into continuous delivery, which the foundation of that is continuous testing.
Yep.
So when I look at, you know, I need to evolve an organization into continuous testing so that we're checking code in, we're testing it all the time across all the environments before it goes to production.
Yep.
To make that happen, you have to have automated test cases.
Mm-hmm.
To have an automated test case means I have to have the right environments and the right data, so that when I send something down, my test case knows what to evaluate against.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm always evaluating against known data.
Yep.
The problem that I've seen has been not having stable environments.
Yeah.
You know, there's lack of environments, I've only got short windows, those kinds of things really kind of jam things up. So with service virtualization, we developed the concept about 10 years ago, and it was the idea of, hey, I can listen and learn, and I can replace that application downstream.
Yep.
And I can stand it up in a developer's environment, I can stand it up in a QA environment, I can stand it up in a performance test environment.
Yep.
So we've seen rapid changes from an efficiency and quality perspective.
Oh, yeah.
And getting, you know, because now everything's about, when we talked about brand, digital transformation, your app is your brand.
It is.
And if you mm-hmm. don't get that right, you're in trouble. Your yeah. competition will eat you alive.
Yep.
So it's now about not only getting things to market fast, but they better be fast and work.
Yeah, and be good.
So, yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Yep,
otherwise,
absolutely.
The App Store, you're a one star on the App Store,
yeah.
and they're ruthless on
yeah.
the App Store with comments. So.
Well, they are, and people look at those, right?
Oh,
and
yeah.
they see that, and they're making buying decisions just based on that, right?
Yeah.
A lot of people see that one data point and go,
yeah.
done. Like,
yeah.
I'm not even bothering with this.
Yeah, I mean, banking, to me, one of my favorite stories is in banking.
Mm-hmm.
You know, look at the first company that put out, I can deposit checks with my phone.
Yeah.
And now all the other banks follow suit.
Yep.
So
yep.
it's the, hey,
absolutely.
I'm getting this out there earlier, making things easier for my customers, and
yeah.
I'm gonna pick up some more customers. You always yep. gotta worry about customer churn.
Yep.
I have a telco background as well, and that was big in the telco world, was customer churn.
Yeah.
So you've gotta find a way to slow that down, and it's now more rapid with the digital transformation.
Oh yeah, and people are less, you know what I find interesting too, consumers have transformed, just
mm-hmm.
like organizations are. And the brand loyalty is very different, right?
Yeah.
If you would look at people before, like, again, take your banking example, people would pick a bank and you would stick with it for your entire life, probably.
Right.
But now, with the way consumers are, if they have a bank, if they don't like it,
mm-hmm.
they're not afraid to say, but I'm done, I'm moving my money.
Exactly.
You know? And they'll be gone and they'll be off to someone else. You look at cell phone companies,
yep.
right? I mean, cell phone companies, people will switch those on a dime.
Oh,
you
yeah.
know, providers for their cable and internet service will switch those mm-hmm. if they're not keeping up. And like you said, that
yeah.
churn exists there
yeah.
for a lot of consumers on
yeah.
a lot of different fronts.
Yeah, I mean, things are so much more accessible.
Oh yeah.
It's just so much, it's just happening so much faster. I mean,
yep.
I mean, back in the telco days in the 90s, it was there, but it wasn't as rampant. And
yeah.
now, yeah, you're right. With cell phones, I go online and, oh, this carrier has a better plan.
Yeah.
I'm gone.
Yep.
And I can walk into their store or even do it online and,
yeah.
and take my number with me.
Yep.
To the next carrier.
Mm-hmm.
So you don't have to worry about, oh, I got to change my number, I need a new number. And there was
yep.
always that fear.
Yep.
But now when they put in local number portability,
yep.
that really changed the game.
Oh, it did. I mean, and it changes a lot. So there's a lot of advancements that are helping consumers, you know, be
yeah.
more savvy and be able to switch more frequently.
Right.
So having the tools, the right technologies to help ensure your testing before you get it out to that consumer is solid is so important.
Right.
You know, and I remember it used to be, in companies, you would talk about for environments to get ready for testing, just when they would, you know, move code into an environment, you were talking
right.
hours, or if not days,
sure.
to get it where
yeah,
it worked.
Absolutely.
And all the code was working, just where you could run a smoke test, everything passes, and now I can actually do my real testing.
Yep. Yep.
I mean, that could be hours to days
oh,
to
yeah.
get there.
Yeah.
And that's huge if you waste that much time just waiting for your environments versus having them readily available, spun up with
right.
the right data that's consistent to run those automated tests to get you results.
Yeah, and that's the fact we've seen a lot with our customer base is we're taking wait time out of schedules and collapsing the schedules down. So you have a domino
yeah.
effect. If
yeah.
I can make development more efficient and ship higher quality code to QA,
yeah.
QA becomes more efficient and they can get done sooner and get to 100% test coverage.
Yeah.
Getting higher quality code to production. So the whole thing domino effects and slices
wow.
down. I mean, you would see easily a customer go from a 12-week release cycle to an 8-week release cycle
yeah.
in no time.
Yep.
I could see, you know, testing cycles going from, it took 3 months to do performance testing, now it's a matter of hours.
Yep.
You know, because now I've got full access to things, I don't have to wait, I can do,
yeah.
and I can do full production performance loads that I expect to see.
Right, that you couldn't
know,
do before.
As opposed to before it's like, I can test at this point, then we're gonna extrapolate and see what happens.
Yeah.
And that never works.
No, right. So having that access and that capability, now when you guys go into organizations and you're saying, we're gonna help you figure out what the right process is and then help
yeah.
set that up, because it's not just the tool part of it, it's actually getting the process correct so that they can mm-hmm. leverage the capabilities of the tools.
Yep.
What does that cycle look like, or how long on average are we talking to get, you know, to them to a point where they're seeing some of these benefits?
You can actually start seeing the benefits right away. As
mm-hmm.
we go through, we were doing value releases for many years,
mm-hmm.
what we call the value release with the customers. And what, you know, we would typically see about a 12-week cycle,
yeah.
or, you know, anywhere from 6 to 12 week cycle for implementations, because you're doing, depending on how large the implementations were.
Yeah.
But you would see within the first couple of weeks, you would start seeing the benefits come out.
Mm.
I mean, immediately.
Wow.
So it was one of those, you didn't have to wait 6 or 12 weeks to
mm-hmm.
say, did I benefit or not? You knew right away.
Yeah.
Because I can get, you know, access to things. And they're like, wow, you know, we used to, hey, you just took out 3 days of wait time.
Yeah.
Right away, because you now gave me access to a system that took me until mid-month to get.
Right.
You know, that kind of thing.
Yeah. So you can see that value a lot quicker, which
mm-hmm.
again, you know, a lot of times executives' barrier to entry is how long till I see something,
sure.
right? How long till we can actually see an improvement or a benefit or ROI against these
yeah.
things? So
yeah, I mean, in the software, buying software has changed. You know, mm-hmm. back in the early 2000, it was, you know, I'll buy anything, I don't care.
Right.
Now it's the, or if your ROI is not at least one, not a maximum of 1 year,
yeah.
you know, it can't be 1 year or less. If it's yeah. not that, you're out.
Yeah.
And that's something that we really focus on with our customers is, you know, we don't want to just see what your technical challenge is. We want to understand what the value behind that is.
Yeah.
Because if there's not a value, your company's not going to invest in making that change.
Right.
Right. And that's, so I think that's where some of the frustration and change exists because like, well, you know, I have this one little problem. Like, okay, well, let's find the big problem.
Yeah.
And we look at that big problem and I guarantee you your company's going to change that. Mm-hmm. They're going to want to change that because of the value behind it.
The value behind the bigger problem.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. And we were talking to someone the other day about part of transformation is a value stream analysis,
yes.
right? So you look at your value stream and your process and what you do and then find those big boulders that you've got to move that are creating large delays
absolutely.
In your releases. And this can be one of them,
yeah,
obviously.
Absolutely. And we do a lot of that value stream analysis with our customers
yeah.
to talk about, you know, what are those big rocks?
Mm-hmm.
What does it really mean from a cost perspective?
Yeah.
And if you change it, does the company care?
Yeah.
Does it move the needle?
Yeah. Is it going to make a difference?
Yeah. And you know, it's amazing. Sometimes like, oh, if we just do this, you know, we're going to buy it if we do this. You start really analyzing. It's like, nah, I've seen it. I've been around it too long.
Yeah.
I know what's going to happen.
Mm-hmm.
So that kind of things, and our customers really appreciate that to see.
Yeah.
You know, that we're trying to partner with them. I mean,
yeah.
it's like, you know, we want to make sure you're successful in doing the right things.
Yep.
Because that's what then gets the big win.
Yeah.
And then going forward, then you start getting that transformation going out across their company.
Yep.
Otherwise, you go do this step and you don't succeed. Now you've just, everybody yeah. that wants to be against the transformation
yeah.
is winning.
Yep, exactly. I mean, they have ammunition, right,
yeah,
for why
exactly.
it didn't work. So you
right.
do want it to be successful. And,
yeah.
you know, unfortunately, people create opinions based on points.
Mm-hmm.
So you could really yep. get one shot at that, right?
Right?
Just like you do with consumers when they delete apps
yeah.
when they don't work.
Right,
like,
exactly.
You get one really good shot
yeah.
at this. You want to do it right. Any suggestions for people out there who are saying, okay, this all sounds amazing. How
yeah.
do I engage or start to get more information on where my big hurdles are and if this fits the problems I'm seeing or
sure.
if there's value there for me?
Yeah, I mean, the biggest thing to do is look at, you know, what you do today and you know, look at what you're doing today and then look at what the things that are blocking you from where you want to go.
Mm-hmm.
So we kind of call it like a current state versus future state.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's when you look at those things that are blocking you from getting to that point, then it's like, okay, why is that? Right,
mm-hmm.
why can't I get there? And then what can I do to remove it?
Yeah.
And once I know why I can't get there and if I remove it and what the value is, then we can talk about here's the solutions to make that happen.
Yeah, that sounds great.
Yeah.
And it's hard to believe we're almost out of time
yeah,
here.
It went fast.
It goes fast. But if people say, Kenneth, I want to talk to you, I want to know more, how do they find you?
You can go to ca.com. And you can look under there's many solutions there, but look under our development area and you'll see things for service virtualization. You'll see things for continuous delivery director, test data management, agile requirements designer. That's a lot of the stuff that we'll build into the continuous testing portion.
Very good. Thanks, Kenneth,
right,
for being here with us.
You.
I appreciate it.
I appreciate your time. Thank you.